How excited are you guys for a matchup like Georgia, knowing they're number three?
Yeah, definitely really excited. I mean, not too many times that you get to go in there and play a team that's supposed to be in the college football playoffs, let alone play in front of 90,000 plus. So really excited. With that being said, I mean, we're not scared to go in there. Made a big emphasis of we're not going there for like a show and tell, like this is Georgia. No, we're going in there to play a football game, take the fight to them. So
It's gonna be a new experience for me, you know. It's gonna be a way bigger crowd than I've ever seen before, and it's kind of close to my hometown, so I got a lot of relatives coming. I mean, it's gonna be a cool experience, but like you said, we're coming in there to play football just like them. It's gonna be a good matchup, and it's gonna test what we can do.
Is there any way you guys can add onto that? There are a lot of guys that are kind of hometowns or here at Georgia. Does this feel like homecoming for you guys in a way?
I mean, I'm being from California, West Coast. Right. I think 8 people coming from out there. I know I have a roommate from Australia. His whole family's coming. So it is definitely a week where like everyone's family's coming. Everyone's family will be there. We'll be kind of have our own racer family there amongst their crowd. So that'll be neat.
Yeah. Anthony, just talking about defensively, last game out, except for the final 3:10 of the second quarter, a really good performance. Did you guys kind of hear about that whenever you went over film?
I mean, we heard definitely the goods, but more breakdowns on what we need to fix going into this game. Definitely in the run game, where there was a lot of plays where we should have been fitting gaps that we weren't fitting. So we still made the play, but it's going to be a bigger emphasis, especially an opponent like this who will get in 2 tight end sets and run the ball downhill. We don't really see that a lot defensively, where in the OVC no one really gets under center, lines up in that old school style of football, but that'll definitely be a big point of emphasis, is fitting the run this week compared to last week. So,
Brion, tell us about your, I know you get limited snaps, but made the most of it the other night. Talk about the transition to football and how it's been for you.
It's been great. I mean, I played football in high school, so I always had the feel for the game. But as now, I'm still learning everything. You know, I'm still trying to get to know more stuff in my position. I mean, I'm not mad or anything about the limited plays I get, but I just go and show my all that I can do.
Now, I've heard 2 schools of thought. Mitch told me on the coaching show last night, you meant to hit the crossbar, not dunk it. So you can set the record straight. Tell me about it.
I actually meant to hit the crossbar. If, like, you look at the video, you can see my arm, like, bent like this. I actually tried it because it was people behind the goalpost, so I didn't want to throw it over and hit one of them. And then I know the ref was going to call a flag, so I was like, I'm at like I'm not trying to touch it, just throw it against the goalpost, but, you know, I still got the flag.
Anthony, obviously last year, one of the racer experiences was to play Kentucky in that big atmosphere. Is that, going in another SEC house, is that going to be a familiar feeling for you?
Familiar is in terms of, yes, in terms of the stadium and the crowd, but I also think there's a big difference between a drop from 3-ranked Georgia to, I think, Kentucky was 9. So I think there's a big drop in difference there. But, I mean, we've definitely played in a big stadium, big atmosphere before. And even in that Kentucky game, looking back, I mean, we were a couple of drop balls away from being in there in the first half. I think it was like 17-3 at the end of the first half. So, yeah, I mean, we're familiar playing SEC opponents, but just from that game. But, I mean, Georgia is a bigger drop-off, I think, from that. So, looking forward to that opportunity now.
Seeing all the different upsets over the weekend, does that kind of give you all a little motivation, a little confidence going forward?
It definitely does. There's a lot of upsets. It was cool playing Thursday, so we could actually get one weekend to at least watch some college football games. But definitely motivated us. I think a lot of FCS teams are motivated to get in there, because I feel like a lot of players that play FCS just are talented. They just didn't have the same exposure as some of the other players that got into FBS schools. I mean, our receiving core alone has a lot of talent in it, so proves shows for itself.
Have you guys begun to talk about Georgia at all, or is that something you guys will scheme about in the next 2 or 3 days?
So we started yesterday scheming for Georgia. After that Sunday, we watched the tape of the last game, and then once Monday starts, it's Georgia from there. So every single day we come in, we're getting new packets, new formations about Georgia, what they do and stuff like that. But starting yesterday was our game plan for Georgia. So,
Mitch grew up kind of a Georgia Bulldog fan, an SEC football fan. Is that something you guys maybe relish, you know, in the classroom and in the locker room? Like, get to go back to kind of his home stomping grounds and things like that?
I mean, for what I know he's close friends with the head coach, so I know he's been with him and know him and got close to him as close friends, so that's all he really talked about. I haven't heard much about him going back home to his stomping grounds, though.
Yeah,